Hello and welcome to a new short series that I'm starting on robotic process automation using the Power Automate desktop. So this is a pretty exciting series that I'm starting, a pretty short one. I'm not going to do too many videos on it. But what I'd like to share with you is how you can leverage this newer feature that's within Power Automate for doing Power Automate desktop solutions in UI flows, and desktop flows is what they're called now, to be able to automate some legacy applications that you might have. So the whole idea, if you're really not familiar too much with what the Power Automate desktop is about, it's all about taking some of these older legacy applications that you might have that run on a machine, a physical workstation, and you want to be able to automate processes that you can't do today. So maybe there's no API that's tied to the application. There's no way to very easily build in your own automations. So what the Power Automate desktop allows you to do is actually take those elements that you have on your desktop or have on remote desktops and be able to automate those processes and even automate the clicks and typing that you might do and be able to pass in parameters and do all sorts of really cool things to be able to automate these tasks that you maybe in the past didn't think were possible to automate at all. The other really neat thing is that desktop flows can be very easily integrated in with cloud flows. In fact, most often you probably would not have a desktop flow without a corresponding cloud flow that executes and schedules those desktop flows for you. So that's what we're going to be looking at in this series, is kind of an exploration into what desktop flows are and how you can use them. And I'll show you some varying different examples of how they can be used. And in this short video, what I'm going to be exposing you to is how the Power Automate desktop can be used. I'll also be showing you a brief example of how you can tie in Power Automate desktop into some other familiar Power Platform tools like the Power BI desktop. And what we're going to be specifically looking at in this example is how we can take, you can see the title of it here, how we can automate data refreshes with inside the Power BI desktop. So if you're someone that works within Power BI, then you realize normally if you want to refresh data in a Power BI solution, you have to publish it to the Power BI service and refresh it in the web browser there. So we're going to be walking you through how you can actually set that up on a more regular basis and also refresh just your desktop file so you never have to deploy to the service. Now, don't get me wrong. Let me make sure I specify this. This is not a great workaround. I'm more showing you this for a use case to show you things you can do. The licensing cost of Power Automate with RPA, that's robotic process automation, is about $40 per person a month. So this is not necessarily a cheaper way to get around the refreshes. It's just an alternative to show you some other things that you could be doing here. All right, so here's our plan. I'm going to show you, and we'll go ahead and just share my screen here for a moment. I want to show you our plan. What I'd like to do is to take this solution that is actually from the Dashboard in a Day class that Microsoft has for Power BI, and I'd like to automate the refreshing process that I have with inside of this desktop tool. Now, it's totally a desktop tool. If I want to refresh this today, the proper way to do that is to publish this to the Power BI service and then refresh it. However, I'd like to show you how the Power Automate desktop can actually make this method and make this solution a lot smoother and a lot easier to be able to automate these different processes. So what I want to show you first is where you can go download and get the Power Automate desktop. So if you want to get the Power Automate desktop, you would go to find underneath My Flows. This is inside flow.microsoft.com. Underneath My Flows, you'll find Desktop Flows. And if you haven't, if you've yet to download the desktop tool, the Power Automate desktop, when you go to hit Create a Desktop Flow, you'll be prompted to download it. You'll also see in the top right here where you can install the Power Automate desktop. The other thing that you'll eventually need, we're not going to cover this in this video, but you'll also eventually need something called the on-premises data gateway, and that creates the secure bridge between your machine that's running these applications and the cloud service, that being Power Automate. Okay, so eventually we'll talk more about the on-premises data gateway, but for today we're going to be focused on the Power Automate desktop. Once you download and install the Power Automate desktop, you'll be able to find it on your machine. And you can just select and search for Power Automate desktop. And it's going to look something like this. And this is actually the completed solution for another example we're going to be looking at later. But this is what the Power Automate desktop looks like initially when you launch it. It's pretty plain, not a whole lot going on with it. You'll notice up in the top right that you are connected into your environments. I'm using a demo admin account here. And you want to make sure that you are pointed to the environment that you want to sync up with any kind of cloud flows that you might do. So you have two types of flows. You saw this in the web browser just a moment ago. You have desktop flows as well as cloud flows. Cloud flows are that more traditional type of flow you've been working with. You have desktop flows, and then you also have business process flows as well. So we're going to be focused on desktop flows for this example. And so what I want to do is I'm going to create a new desktop flow. So from the Power Automate desktop, I'm going to select new. We'll go ahead and give this new flow a name, and I'll call it refresh. You can see I have this one already created once, but I'm going to call this refresh Power BI desktop and then hit create. And when you do that, it's going to launch open the Power Automate Desktop Designer, which launched on a different screen for me. And I'm going to bring it over here so we can take a look at it. All right. Now, the cool thing about how the Power Automate Desktop works is you can actually record tasks that you do within these applications. So it will record every click and every type that you do, everything you type or everything you click will be recorded and added in here as an action that you can either modify, you can parameterize, you can do a whole lot of interesting stuff with. So for this example, what I want to start with is pointing out that you have hundreds of actions here on the left-hand side. There are tons of things that you can choose from. You may want to even search through and find things that might be interesting to you. So things like if I search Outlook, you'll find that there's a bunch of different Outlook type tasks that you can, There's a bunch of different Outlook tasks that you can find. If you want to search for Excel, you'll find there's Excel tasks that you can work with as well. So there's a lot of things that are available with inside of the Power Automate desktop. For our example, though, we want to start by telling the Power Automate desktop that we want to launch the Power BI desktop. And we want to not only launch the Power BI desktop, but we want to launch a specific file and open a specific file when we launch the Power BI desktop. So the way we can do that is we're going to go search for a feature or an action called Run Application. Okay. And you'll see it's underneath the system section here. And you can always search for it, by the way, if you just scroll down and find the system section right here, you can find the Run Application option right here. And so I'm going to go ahead and click and drag the Run Application option or action into the design surface in the workspace in the middle. And then you're going to specify which application do you want to launch. And so in this case, I have a file that I have already specified here that we can browse to. And if you select the little application icon here where it says select a file, I can search for that file. And it's this specific one here called Dashboard in a Day Final Report. Okay. So I'm going to select that one file and then click open. I don't really need to do anything else here. I don't need to parameterize it in any way. So I'm going to go ahead and hit save. And then we are good to go. All right. So this is our launch application. So that's all this is doing is it's going to launch the Power BI desktop. But it's also going to launch a specific file. If I wanted to open an empty Power BI desktop, then I would point to the Power BI desktop exe file. Okay. Next, I want to automate some tasks that we might do when we're inside the Power Automate desktop. Okay. So the way I can do this is using the desktop recorder that comes along with the Power BI, Power Automate desktop. I want to automate some tasks that we would do while we have Power BI open. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and click on the desktop recorder. Okay, and I'll close my PowerPoint here for a moment and get that out of the way. And with the desktop recorder open, I'm going to bring that over here so we can see it. With the desktop open recorder open, we'll hit start recording, and then we're going to tell it the different tasks that we want it to do in here. So we might want to click on the refresh button. So what's a good thing to do before you use the desktop recorder is plan out what you're going to do. So here it's really three actions. I want to hit the refresh button, let it do the refresh. Then I want to go up to the close option up in the top right. And then I want to make sure that it saves those changes that we've made whenever we hit the close option. All right. So really three actions there. All right. So for this use case here, we're going to go ahead and hit start recorder. The recorder is now started. And as we click around on the design surface, you'll see these little red boxes start to appear on my screen. And you want to give them time to actually populate because when you select that, whatever you click within the red box is going to be recorded on that desktop recorder. So if I click refresh right here, not only is it going to do the refresh, but it's also going to create a step over here or an action over here within my desktop recorder. So I'm going to go ahead and let it do its thing, do a refresh here. And when it's done refreshing, we're then going to go hit the close button. And then we're going to save, and it should close out the application. So we're going to save these steps. Now, it seems pretty simple, but there are a few things that will become a little bit of a hiccup that we'll need to plan for. So I'm going to guide you through some of those as we begin to use this example here. All right, so we'll let this finish doing its thing. Australia is a little bit of a bigger file here, but it should be just about done. There it goes, through all the other files. And once it's done, we will go ahead and close out of this desktop instance. All right, so the refresh is done. Now we're going to go up to the top menu here and hit close. You'll see it captures that in the desktop recorder. And then we're going to hit save. All right, so those things have now been saved into the desktop recorder. And I can hit finish. And this will now bring these steps into the Power Automate desktop. Okay, so we're looking at the Power Automate desktop. You can see that right here. I've named the flow on the left. The application is named on the right. And so I can see these three steps have been brought in. In addition to the step we already had, run our application, and then here it kind of groups these together as auto-generated actions from the recorder. So these are just groupings. You can either keep this grouping here or keep this grouping if you want, or you can remove them. But what we're going to do is there's a few things here that, you know, won't work totally perfectly. If we actually save this and we try and run this flow, there's going to be a few hiccups. So let's go ahead and take a look at what those hiccups are. So I'm going to go ahead and hit run. And when you do hit run, you want to take your mouse, your hand off the mouse, your hands off the keyboard, because it's actually going to physically run these steps on your desktop. So you want to make sure you're not touching anything as it does that. All right, so it's attempting to launch this. It should hit the refresh button for me here shortly. And actually, it already didn't work. So we already ran into an issue. It should have hit that refresh button for me, but it didn't work. So let's see why. I'm going to go ahead and close this out. And you'll see down here on the bottom that it wasn't able to find the refresh button. And part of this is a timing thing. We're moving too fast in here. We told it to launch the Power Automate desktop, to launch the Power BI desktop with this file. Then we told it to hit the refresh button. We told it to click on this image. We told it to click on the save button. And it's doing all these things rather quickly, and it's not able to keep up. So what you can do is you can add in different little wait steps in here. We can tell it to actually wait, and you don't just have to tell it to wait a certain amount of time. You can actually tell it to wait until it finds certain things that are appearing on your screen. So what I can do is I can say, hey, I want you to wait until the refresh button is actually visible. So there's an option here where I can say, wait for Windows content, and I can drag and drop this into my steps, my actions. And I can say, wait for Windows content. Well, what I want you to wait for is whenever you see and whenever the UI content is available for my refresh button. So if you don't see my refresh button available, then don't press it. Once you do see it's available, and by the way, you see these nice little screenshots here are really helpful. But once that refresh button is available, then you're allowed to push it. But don't try and push it beforehand. All right, so I'll hit select and hit save. And now we've added that little wait step in. Now I'll go ahead and ruin the punchline here. We need to add in wait steps basically after each one of these elements because it's going to try and rush its way through each of these steps. So if I were to save this and actually run it again, we're going to run into another problem. Let me go ahead and run it, and you'll see the new problem that we're going to run into here. The new problem that we're going to run into is, yes, it will wait for the refresh button to appear. However, it's not able to then wait for the close button in the top right to be available after that. And then the save button's not visible, but it's going to try and click the save button. So yes, we're going to solve one problem. You'll see the refresh works now, but then we're going to have new issues with our other elements. So this will eventually fail on us as well. So I'm going to go ahead and cancel this before it fails because I already know it's going to fail. And what we're going to do is we're going to, you can see it already did fail here. So what we want to do is we're going to add in some new wait steps in here to tell it to wait for our close image to be available. We're going to tell it to wait for the save button to be visible. So there's a few different things that we're going to do in here. All right, so what I want to do next is I want to tell it to wait to go to my close button. This would be the little X icon that we have here. So wait to click on the little X icon in the top right until the refresh box, that box where it's doing the refresh, has popped up and disappeared. So that I need to tell the Power Automate desktop to expect that pop-up to occur, and then don't do anything until that pop-up disappears. And so we're going to add in a couple more wait steps right here. So we're going to tell it that we want, excuse me, not right there, but right here, right before we tell it to click on the image. We're going to add in two wait steps here. One to wait for the refresh to be visible, and then another one to wait for the refresh to disappear. All right, so here's how we're going to do that. This part's a little tricky. What you're going to do is you can actually tell it to look for different UI elements in here, and you can tell it to look for some of the existing buttons that are already on your screen that are part of the steps that you already have within the recorder, or you can tell it to add a totally new UI element that you haven't done yet. So So we're going to add in a totally new UI element, and we're going to tell it to look for that box where it's refreshing all the data inside of our model. So we're going to tell it to add a new UI step, and then we're going to go over to the Power BI desktop. So we'll launch that back up and open. And then you'll notice when you look at this tracking session, notice here it tells you you need to do a control left click to be able to capture this element that you want to use here. So what that means is whenever I go to click the refresh button, I'm going to click on control click to capture that little element there. Okay. And what that does is it means that this new box, this dialog box that pops up for my refresh is now captured, and I can use that for my data refresh process here. All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell it that I want to wait for this content to be visible. Okay. So you can see here content UI element. And I've selected the content UI element here just a moment ago when we hit this dropdown and we selected add a new element. And you can see the screenshot over here as well. All right, so that should fix that step. Now, there's also going to be another problem. We need to then wait for that content element to disappear. Think about this. We can't actually click on the red X in the top right while this refresh button option is still available. So we need to actually have another content element to look for when that screen disappears. When that screen disappears, then we're allowed to click the red X in the top right. All right, so it feels a little complicated, right? But it's actually not once you get to play around with it a little bit here. So there's a little trick to do this. So rather than me having to do that whole element again, you can actually copy this action and you can duplicate it. So I can copy and then just do Control V to paste it if I wanted to. Now you can see it appears here again. And so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to tell it that I want to edit this step. You can right-click and click Edit, or you can hit the little ellipses on the far right and click Edit. And we're going to tell it that we want to make it so that when we don't see that UI element, when we don't see that refresh box, then we want to move on to the next step. All right, we'll talk through this whole flow here in a moment. But so far we have open up the Power BI desktop, click the refresh button, wait for the refresh button to be available. That's what the first one does. Then click the refresh button, wait for the refresh box to appear, and then wait for it to disappear. And then it's allowed to click the little X image to close out in the top right. When it does that, we're going to add in one more wait step between image and the save button to make it so that it waits for the save button to be visible as well. Because just when you click the X button, the save button is not visible immediately. So we need to have it wait one more moment right here. We're going to add in another wait step and tell it that we want it to wait for the save button to be visible. Okay, so don't try and save before saving's even an option, essentially is what we're saying. All right, so we'll hit save on that and hit save again. And this flow is now complete. All right, so we're opening, we're refreshing, we're waiting for the refresh to complete. We're closing out the Power BI desktop. Then we're waiting until we can actually click the save button before we click save. All right, so let's test this out. I'm going to actually close out of the Power BI desktop for a moment. Because remember, part of our step is to actually launch the Power BI desktop. We're going to save this flow that we've created, this desktop flow, and then I'm going to run it to test it out. So I'm going to go ahead and hit run right here. Now, when you do that, again, make sure you take your hands off the keyboard and mouse. You don't want to interrupt anything that might launch as you're doing that. So it is launching the Power BI desktop for me. It's now going to click the refresh button when it's available, but not before then. Okay, give it a second. There it goes. It just clicked the refresh button. Now it's told to wait here on the refresh screen until it disappears. So when the refresh screen disappears, then you're allowed to go close the Power BI desktop and save the file. So we'll give this a few moments here for it to go ahead and run through its refresh process. And this will take, I think, another 30 or 45 seconds here. So while we're waiting for that refresh to finish, let's talk through how powerful this can be. This is incredibly powerful, right? So this is just one application, and I try to tie it into the Power Platform to show you how these Power Platform tools can work together. But really, there's a lot of cool stuff you can do with this. You could tie this into any of your kind of old invoicing systems that you might have. If you have some legacy systems, some legacy applications, you'll notice right now that we're running this as an attended user, which means it's actually doing everything on my screen. And that's why I keep telling you, hey, don't do anything on your keyboard and mouse while it's running. Oh, let's see. It looks like it just saved. It closed. And let's see if it goes away. Boom, it went away. So it worked. So we were able to take this solution, pull it all together, and create this automation of a desktop application, which is really, really powerful. So there's lots of different ways you can use this. I show this with Power Platform just to tie things within the Power Platform together. this isn't a great use case because the RPA licensing actually isn't any cheaper than just doing a Power BI license. In fact, it's more expensive. But it shows you how you can tie some of these things together. And if you had an old legacy system that had an application that had to have human interaction, the goal here is to eliminate that human interaction and be able to automate some of these processes. You can also pass in parameters. So I can make it so that parameters are passed in with variables. You'll see variables in the top right over here. I can overwrite and kind of pass in variables. Let me show my screen one more time. In the top right, you'll see there's variables up here. So you can pass in variables and make it so that it's really easy for your users to not only run automated desktop solutions, but also parameterize them and make them dynamic. So really, really powerful. This is my first video on this series. Hopefully you enjoyed it. We're going to be looking at, in the future, at some more advanced things that we can do with the Power Automate desktop, like how would we schedule this to occur? How could we run this unattended? How could we, for instance, maybe I want to do some more things in Power BI and show you how we can do some things automated using the desktop tool. So we're going to look at a few things like that as we get going, but that's it for this one. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Let me know if you have any questions below. We have also at Pragmatic Works right now an RPA in a day class, so robotic process automation in a day class for free. So you can sign up. We'll have some links below. You can sign up for our robotic process automation class in a day absolutely free. And let us know what you think. Let us know if you're interested in some more videos like this to see how you can use the Power Automate desktop on your environment as well. Thank you so much, and look forward to chatting with you soon. Thank you.